Again, welcome back one more time, my dear kids. Hope all are very, very safe at home. All are enjoying their life. And also hoping that all are enjoying physics, okay? This is Mithun Raj, your science teacher. Signing in from Cochin, Kerala, this part of the world. And I think this is the third video log regarding the electricity part, okay? First two, it was only introduction. Leave it, it's only concepts and all. This is the first part. We already started electricity, okay? We already started. And it will become a bit more difficult as we continue. So the first derivation of this chapter, one mark question will come from this part, okay? One mark question. Yesterday we discussed about open circuits and closed circuits and all. I hope you understand that one, that you keep it in mind. And the about the direction of flow of current. How the current flows? Current flows from positive to negative. Conventional flow of electric current. That means for years we believed that. Because of that, till now also we are continuing that. When the electron was discovered, after that we came to know that current really flows from negative part to the positive part. Okay. But for nowadays we are using which direction? Leave this one. Take the up direction, this one, okay? From positive to negative, keep that in mind. Not from right to left, from positive to negative. Anyway, while we are dealing with that circuits and all, you will understand that, no problem. So the formula for current. Current is represented by the letter I and its unit is ampere. Understand? Ampere, which is represented by the capital letter A. And this Coulomb is been this scientist, actually his name is Coulomb, and he is the one who discovered that charge. That's why it is given his name. And what is one Coulomb? One Coulomb is equal charge contained in how many electrons? 6 × 10⁻¹⁸. Just imagine, one Coulomb is the charge of what? You know, these electrons have charges. Come back. See, here how many electrons are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So, one Coulomb is what actually? It is the charge contained in 6 × 10⁻¹⁸. Isn't it a big number or not? After 6, there will be 18 zeros. How much big number it is? This is like 606,6,000 crores, something like that. I am not sure it is correct or not. Okay. So this much electrons charge. Understand, that many electrons charge is one Coulomb. That means if you want to calculate one Coulomb from this diagram, there must be 6 × 10⁻¹⁸ electrons. That charge is Coulomb's one Coulomb. Understood? This is only four. Like this, that 6 × 10⁻¹⁸ electrons must be there. That is one Coulomb charge. Understand? Anyway, you know that electrons are very, very small. That means they are carrying only a very few amount of charge. Understand? But in a real conductor, there are how many millions of electrons we cannot count. That's why that much amount of charge is coming. And electric current is what? 1 ampere is 1 Coulomb divided by 1 second. Understood? 1 Coulomb divided by 1 second. So, SI unit of current is ampere, no doubt about that. Okay, SI unit of current is ampere, 100% no doubt. But really, what is ampere? Ampere is Q by T, means Q, charge means Coulomb, time means second. Coulomb by second is also the standard unit of what? Current. Understand? This question came at least 2 or 3 times and lots of students, they were mistaking it. Lots of students, they wrote none of these. Ampere was not given. The question was like, which is the standard unit of current? The options were meter per second, coulomb per second, volt per second. None of these. Lots of students wrote none of these. Actually, the real SI unit of current is Coulomb per second. Q means charge. Charge unit is Coulomb. T means time, times unit is second, coulomb per second is equal to current or 1 ampere of current. Okay, Q is the net charge and T is the time and I is the current. Simple definition. So this man discovered that. For to value his discovery, we named that standard unit as coulomb. Okay, C-O-U-L-O-M-B, coulomb. Column, column, column. And electron has how much charge? One electron has 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb charge. It's a very, very small charge. 10 raised to minus 19 means, how we will write? From here we need to put the point here. 19 points we need to carry from this 0.6 to there. Understood? It's a very, very, very small charge. Okay? This is the, remember this, we need to derive another equation from this. This is the charge of one electron. How we will get this? Just divide, 1 divided by this. Isn't it? 1 divided by 6 into 10 raised to 18 will give this value. Anyway, that question is there to derive. See, calculate the number of electrons constituting one coulomb of charge. How will you get that? How many electrons? I think the blah blah blah. It is coming correctly. The focus is gone. What is happening to my? Now I think it's fine. Okay. We need to find number of electrons constituting one coulomb of charge. We already know that it is 6 into 10 raised to 18, isn't it? Just leave it. 6.25, approximately we are taking it as 6. What we have? We have already, it is mentioned that one electron charge is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb, isn't it? And what we have? We want to find how much charge is there in one coulomb. So how we will find it out? 1 divided by that charge. Isn't it? Let's see. 1 divided by 10 raised to minus 19 will go up. When the square go up, it will change the sign. So negative will become positive and positive will become negative. So simply it will go up means 10 raised to 19 divided by 1.6. 1 divided by 1.6 or 10 divided by 1.6 will give what? 6.25 into 10 raised to 18. It's a simple calculation. I think it's a simple calculation for me. For you, I think it's not a simple calculation, isn't it? Anyway, this much bigger calculation you didn't study before, I hope that. So just try to by heart this, okay? Numericals will come from this part. Only one numerical will come and that is this one, okay? Only one will come, this is. Because electrons, this charge is constant, no other question will come, okay? How to find out this? How to find it out? It's a one mark question and just by heart it. By heart this number, by heart it. That's it. There's nothing very serious regarding that. Okay? And who is this man? Anyway, it's not me. So unit of electric current. So ampere, another important scientist name as Ampere. He did a lots of experiment regarding this electric current. That's why this standard unit named as ampere is given in recognition of, to show him respect, and he is Ampere, another scientist, another physicist who studied regarding electricity. Okay, so one more time I am telling, standard unit of electricity is ampere, no problem, that's also correct. But if ampere is not in the options, coulomb per second is also correct. Understood? Coulomb per second is what? Same, 1 ampere. Am I correct or not? What is ampere? Electric current flowing through a conductor is said to be 1 ampere when 1 coulomb of charge flows through a conductor in 1 second. Same thing. This one. This is 1 ampere. 1 coulomb of charge flows in 1 second. Understand? That is 1 ampere. 1 ampere is what? 1 ampere is equal to 1 coulomb of charge flows in 1 second. Everything we will multiply by 1. one ampere. Okay, one current, one charge, 1 second. That is the definition for 1 ampere. I think there are same this one. This is easy to understand. 1 ampere is 1 ampere equal to 1 coulomb divided by 1 second. Other unit of electric current is like milliampere, 1 milliampere, 1 microampere. You already know what is it. If you don't know, just keep it in mind. Take a screenshot and keep it. Okay. 1 milliampere means 1000 milliampere will give 1 ampere. Understand? So 1 milliampere means 1 divided by 1000 gives 10^-3 ampere. In physics, we are using these types of numbers. Understand? 10^3, 10^6, 10^2. It is very difficult otherwise to calculate and all. That's why I am telling these numericals are difficult for you, because these are the basic things about mathematics, and most of the students are very, very weak regarding these basics. Okay, these are things I think you already studied about this power and all, how to convert this power, isn't it? Okay, microampere means what? 10^-6. Numericals we will solve, then only you will understand. Understood anything? No, right? I know you won't understand. Numericals, while solving numericals, we will see how to convert it into ampere and all. And one more thing, whenever the numericals are coming, listen it. Whenever numericals are coming, you want to solve it by converting it into SI units, okay? And the question is that 10 ampere current, 10 coulomb charge and 1 minute. If it is given 1 minute, what will you do? If you calculate it with one, for example, it is given 100 coulomb of charge or 60 coulomb of charge passes through a wire in 1 minute. How much ampere of current is there? 60 coulomb of charge passes in 1 minute. How much ampere of current is there? Simple question. We know. What is the equation for ampere? 1 ampere equal to 1 coulomb divided by 1 second. But here coulomb is what? 60 coulomb. And time is what? 1 minute. 60 by 1 is 60. Answer is 60 ampere. Is that the correct answer? No. We need to convert this into standard unit. And what is the standard unit of time? Standard unit of time is second. 1 minute is equal to how much seconds? 100 seconds? No. 60 seconds. Okay. Don't tell that you don't know that. So 60 coulomb by 60 second will give 1 ampere. That's the answer. Come on, let's go to the next part. Now again, some easy part came. So this is a simple instrument. You can see it in every science lab. It is called as the ammeter. A is already written here. So it is used for what purpose? It is used for measure the current in a circuit. How many amperes of current is there in circuit? We can measure with the use of this ammeter. Okay? I think it's no need of any explanation. And how to find out it is an ammeter or not? There will be a symbol A at the center of that meter. Okay, this is the meter. This is the needle. It will go here and there. Understand? Here it is negative current also is showing. In most of the ammeters in lab and all, from 0 it will start. Okay, 0 to 0.2, 0.4, 0.6. Okay, so this is an ammeter, and ammeter is used to measure the current. Ammeter is always connected in series. Okay, this one first we must study about series connection and parallel connection, then I will explain this. Now you won't understand. This one to show. Leave it. Anyway, come again, we'll go through that. Ammeter, series connection means what? Two types of connections are there, series connections and parallel connections. Let me see where is the definition of that. Series connection, parallel connection. Series and parallel not there? Oh my God. So it will be difficult for 1 minute? No. Somebody missed that in this part. So what is the difference between this diagram? See, this diagram, this is a series connection, and this diagram. See, in parallel connection, the instrument is connected in parallel with the load. This is the load. Okay, if this is a bulb, we can say this is the load. So this is connected in parallel. See, this is parallel or not, right or not? So this is a voltmeter to measure volt. Volt, what is volt, we will study. But here, this one is connected to series in a straight line. Anyway, this is a bend, but still it is a straight line. Isn't it understood what is a series connection? In detail, we will study. Leave it. So ammeter is always connected in series in a circuit. Okay, because resistivity of ammeter is very low. Resistivity means the ability to hold the current. So whenever the resistivity is low, there is no difference in the value of current in the circuit. So wherever we connect this ammeter, there won't be any change in the value. Okay, that's a two mark question. I think I have the explanation in the later part. Anyway, I will give the explanation next. If you study volt and voltmeter, then it will be easy for you. But before that, you must study the different types of circuits, series circuits and parallel circuits. Series circuit means it is connected straight. Parallel circuit means it is connected parallel to the load. Okay, see, parallel. Voltmeter is a different types of instrument used to measure voltage. Voltage, what is voltage, we will study when you study potential difference. Okay, so potential difference, we will go in next class. What is this? See, the lower resistance, since the entire current passes through. So what is this resistance? We already discussed. If resistance is very low, there won't be any difference in current. All the current will pass through the ammeter. Understand? That's why we can connect it in series. But in the case of voltmeter, resistance is high. That's why it is connected in parallel. You just think this in mind. Okay. If you think about resistivity, voltage, potential difference and all, you won't understand. Just keep this in mind. Ammeter is used to measure current. Okay. Voltmeter is used to measure potential difference or voltage. Voltage we will study next class. Okay. Understood? One particular question was there, that's why it is given here. Ammeter is connected in series and voltmeter is connected in parallel. What is the reason? Because ammeter has less resistance, so that it won't change the value of current flowing in the circuit. But in the case voltmeter has high resistance, so it will change the value of current in the circuit. That's why it is connected in series. Okay, that's a 2 mark question, very important question. Next one is what? Load resistance. Next one is the electrical potential. I think we can continue with this in next class because it's a next phase. Okay, next phase a bit more tough regarding this chapter. So the first part is finished. Okay, the three classes will make it the first part. And I hope you understood all those things. Let's see what all things. Ammeter is a measurement. Okay, this is a device which used to measure current. What is 1 ampere? 1 ampere means 1 coulomb of charge flown in 1 second. And what is 1 coulomb? 1 coulomb is equal to the charge of 6.25 × 10⁻¹⁸ electrons. This is a numerical. Directly you just study that. Anyway, I will give notes. If you want, you can write it in your notes. You must write, not this one. Okay. Anyway, quiz regarding this will follow. You want to do what? You want to thoroughly revise or thoroughly go through this video, and you must. This the scientist's name is important. His name is Coulomb and his name is Ampere. And electricity flowing from actually negative to positive, but conventionally we are using which one? Positive to negative. And in every circuit you are drawing, you must show the direction of current, otherwise you won't get full marks. Many students make this mistake. Simply they are losing mark. Just one arrow mark, if we put, you will get half mark. Just one arrow mark, and that arrow mark must be from positive side of the battery to the negative end. Okay, So that all things are the main things, conductors, insulators. Just, you know what is conductor and insulator, just remember some examples. You will be able to write the definition, no problem that. Open circuit and closed circuit, difference between that. What is an electric circuit? Okay, that's it. Next we will study about the potential difference, and it will be a bit more difficult, and then we will start solving the numericals, and also circuits will be there, circuits. Okay. We will study about circuits in details. Simply a circuit will be there. The question will be to find the total resistance of the circuit, total current of the circuit, total voltage of, total voltage means potential difference of the circuit. So very interesting if you know. If you know the concept, if you know the details and all, it is very interesting. Okay, that's why from the beginning itself revise it. Okay, I will give a mind map regarding this, but that mind map is a very, very complex one. You won't understand that. Anyway, let's hope for the best. Okay, corona situation. Stay home, stay safe. Drink a lot of water, eat good food. Till then, Mithun Raj signing off from this part of the world. Stay home, stay safe, my dear kids. Bye-bye and Jai Hind.